from the perspective of the studio and Tom Holland's representation, I think this is a fantastic first look. Very nice debut for the character. Not only do we see Tom Holland in full costume, but he's on set. So you get the thrill of seeing the character, you know, as a movie character. Of course, he's a very popular video game character. It's almost been a running gag at this point how long it's taken this to jump to the silver screen. So you not only get the excitement of seeing Nathan Drake in the flesh, we'll talk about the reaction to this in just a moment, but also, you know, you get the anticipation that the movie's coming. So I think that's really cool. And the set looks very impressive. Very, very impressive. And he's got all the little details down that you would expect for Nathan Drake. But the question is he Nathan Drake? Or as some people are saying, he looks like he's just dressed up for Halloween like Nathan Drake, and he isn't actually the character. Now, yes, this is trending, last I checked, number 2 on Twitter. At first, I thought that's just because Tom Holland is so massively popular, particularly on social media. Very, very popular. But I took a little bit of a closer look at the trend, what was trending in the tweets that were going out, and it turns out it's controversy. Controversy yet again, fueling why this is trending so high, with some people just excited to see anything with Tom Holland, and others not so happy with what's been done to their game. So you're really dealing with two groups here, Tom Holland stans and Uncharted fans. And the big question, of course, is which is the bigger group? Now, ideally, Sony would like to unite them as one to create a box office juggernaut. And Sony is really investing in Tom Holland. He's, of course, the star of their crown jewel franchise, Spider-Man. And now they've given him another franchise at the studio. Sony makes the Jumanji movies too now, come to think of it. Now, if I were The Rock, I'd be none too pleased about this. But they're like, you know, The Rock's going to do, you know, I don't know when he's going to do another Jumanji, even though a third one has been teased. And it's funny to see Tom Holland so firmly in the Sony camp because, of course, he's like the parent. I mean, he's like the child of divorced parents with Amy Pascal and Kevin Feige. And he's always been like, I really like you, Kevin Feige, and hasn't really wanted to be too much a part of Sony. But this certainly seems to change things, at least when it comes to Uncharted. So fans of the game are not happy, from what I can see. And feel free, of course, and I know you will, to share your own thoughts down below. And also, what group are you in? Are you a Tom Holland stan or an Uncharted fan? And maybe some of you are both, like a four-leaf clover. Hard to find, but maybe you exist. Anyway, fans of the game feel that Tom Holland is too young, too skinny, too clean cut. I mean, on the too young part, you know, ideally for these franchises, especially these days, back in the day, you made 3 movies, you were done. Now you can go, these things go on forever. Fast and Furious is going to wrap up maybe with 11 movies. So this means that Sony could be making Uncharted movies starring Tom Holland for quite some time. That's the plan. But let's see what happens. But that's the plan. So the young part, I don't know if necessarily is a real critique, but the physicality and the look, I think are, you know, I would be a little concerned if I were a Sony executive, because I'd be like, this is what he looks like. This is a great photo of him. If you don't like this, we have a problem. Now, you have to also wonder if Holland stands, I mean, of course they're all excited just to see anything with Tom Holland in it, but you know, his personal image is quite different than Nathan Drake. So will people who love that aspect of him want to see him channeling Indiana Jones meets Aquaman? Can Tom Holland channel Indiana Jones meets Aquaman? Because while that's what Nathan Drake is exactly, that's not really what Tom Holland is. Now, of course, some Tom Holland stans, by the way, will show up to watch him in anything. But how big is that group? Tweets, just like magazine covers, as Hollywood has too often discovered over the decades, don't always translate into movie ticket sales. To me, Tom Holland's strength as a movie star is his earnestness. It's why channeling Michael J. Fox for his Peter Parker was such a perfect fit. It was his idea. It was brilliant. And why he gave off a major Jimmy Stewart vibe in his recent turn in The Devil All the Time, where I thought he did a very nice job. Also, look at the animated characters that he's voiced. Nathan Drake is a big departure from that image that he's been meticulously crafting for quite some time now. But then again, maybe that's the point. It would seem that, like a lot of ingenue actresses, Tom Holland would like to be considered hot, right? You see this happen with a lot of actresses. Now, it never works with any of the actresses, and they always find their careers derailed, and they have to do a lot of work to course correct back to the course that they were already on when they decided to try and go and take a hot detour. It never works out. So I don't know why Tom Holland is trying to do it. But let's see. I mean, it's still just a picture. We don't know how Tom Holland is playing the role. He came up with that Michael J. Fox angle for Peter Parker. Maybe he has something really good here. I think he might be channeling Mark Wahlberg. We'll get to that in a moment. I like Mark Wahlberg, but I don't think the world needs two Mark Wahlbergs. And Mark Wahlberg's box office is, you know, uneven. So I don't know if that's somebody I would want to replicate, right? I mean, Mark Wahlberg's struggling sometimes to be Mark Wahlberg. Also, he will perhaps be a way to balance out the other adventure flicks that are out there right now. Aquaman, Jumanji, right? Tomb Raider, they are making another one, even though nobody wants to see the first one. I liked the first Tomb Raider. I thought it was good. But to me, that underscores another problem here, and that there's already so much of this movie out in the marketplace. So this is going to have to work very hard to differentiate itself. You know, like Aquaman is a comic book movie, Jumanji is a comedy, Tomb Raider has a woman in the lead, right? What's going to make Uncharted stand out? You're like, oh, because it's a famous video game. It's like, well, to moviegoers who don't play that video game, how are you going to say this is different? I mean, I guess you could say it's the video game one, but considering Hollywood's track record with video game adaptations, I don't know if anything wants to be branded that, right? I mean, they're turning it around a little bit, but not to the degree that I think that would be enough to sell it. Now, I do have to say that director Ruben Fleischer has an amazing track record. So I think this picture is in the best hands that it could be. I think he's very savvy. I think he's very good at comedy, which Tom Holland is as well. And I think he's very good at action. So I think that's excellent. And Mark Wahlberg is in this movie. He was originally up to play Nathan Drake, but it's taken so long for the movie to get made. He's aged out of that role, and now he's playing his mentor. A lot of you feel he's miscast as well. But I feel like he's already giving Tom Holland posing tips. I don't know if it's his idea to have Tom Holland act like him. I mean, I guess he is playing his mentor, so Tom Holland's like, so I would try and act like him. But I mean, that's classic Mark Wahlberg right there. He's got the posing, he's got the hair, he's got the expression on his face. And he does look a little bit like Mark Wahlberg. So, but again, I don't know if that's something I would try and do, considering Mark Wahlberg. You know, it's one thing to like try and be like Michael J. Fox or Harrison Ford, but I don't know about Mark Wahlberg. That's an interesting choice. And also, Mark Wahlberg's currently in the space. Usually you want to try and replicate someone who's been gone for a while, and people will be happy to see them back. Again, bringing back Michael J. Fox, that persona for Spider-Man movies. That's why that worked so well. Antonio Banderas and Tati Gabriel are also in the film, and Gabriel is a fantastic choice. She will particularly appeal to Tom Holland's stans. You know, he is very popular with his pairing with Zendaya. They do have a lot of chemistry together. So that's another. But the other question is, will his pairing with Gabriel dilute that because it's very similar? So we'll see. We have to see. But how will fans of the game feel? You know, I think we won't know for sure until we actually see a trailer. I think that's important. This is also reminding me a little bit of Guardians of the Galaxy, to be honest with you, a little Star-Lord, especially when you see like the artifact he's going after with the blue lighting. It's a little Guardians too. But Guardians movies have also been very popular. But again, is this different enough, right? You don't want it to seem derivative. This picture of Tom Holland standing with Nolan North, who originated the character through voice work and motion capture, is a very nice touch. And North better be on the set, not just to take that picture, but to have a cameo. He should have a cameo in the movie. I think it would be horrible if he did not. So what do you think? And again, which group are you in? Are you a Tom Holland stan? Are you an Uncharted fan? Or are you a combination of the two? If so, Sony loves you. All right, share those thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.